God, I want to thank you so much for giving me this day, for giving me this privilege to be up early in the morning to have a productive start to energizing my whole day, Lord. I want to thank you for the privilege and opportunities that you've given me. God, the fact that my heart is beating, my lungs are breathing, and my eyes get to be open indicate that you've given me another day that I get to live and make an impact in this world, Lord. I also just want to thank you for this YouTube channel that you've given me, that I'm able to film videos that can truly serve people, that can inspire people, that can inspire change in the lives of others. Pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, morning, Vince.
Morning.
Happy Friday.
Happy Friday. Yeah, I'm talking to you, Richard. Amelia, say hi to Richard.
Hi, Amelia.
A reframe around CEO, like mm-hmm. You've got to be a chief engagement officer. You're the one responsible for engagement. Two, You have to be the CPS, chief problem solver. Mm-hmm. If you are not a problem solver, you're not an entrepreneur. If you're not the engagement officer, if you don't know how to create engagement, you cannot be an entrepreneur.
Hey, what's going on? It is so good to see you. If you're new to this channel, my name is Richard. I am a recent graduate from UCLA and I'm also an entrepreneur. And I'm actually still at my UCLA apartment because I'm here for another 2 weeks before I fly out to Florida for work. So I'm gonna be here for the rest of today. Today's video is going to be very exciting because I'm gonna be showing you exactly why I wake up at 3:35 a.m. every single day. And I've been doing this for about the past 6 months. Before I explain anything else, I just wanna say you totally do not have to wake up at 3 a.m., 4 a.m., 5 a.m., or even 6 a.m. It's not about how early you wake up, it's about how consistent you wake up, as well as how productive you are during your waking hours. But nevertheless, I wanna explain to you the benefits and why exactly I wake up at 3:35 a.m. So I hope that you enjoy this video. I gotta grab breakfast right now, and then I gotta jump right into some meetings and work, so I'll see you soon in a little bit. I'm listening to a podcast right now. This podcast I would highly encourage any of you to listen to. It's called Born to Impact and It Completely Changed My Life. And the podcast interviewee, Kent Clothier, explains that after going from a medical missions trip coming back from Haiti and coming back to the States, he realized if you wake up and you have your own bed and you have your own room and you have clean air to breathe, fresh water to drink from, you've already won the lottery. And when I woke up this morning, I was just so astounded by, wow, the fact that I get to take a cold shower, that I get to eat food, that I get tap water to drink was such an amazing blessing and something that I've definitely taken for granted for. So before you do anything else in this video, pause it, just take a moment and reflect on how fortunate you are as a person, and then go listen to that podcast. I'm gonna put the link in the description down below. It's a really good podcast. So right now, I'm just about to jump into building out a webinar for my boss and CEO, Vince Delmonte. And before I do so, I wanna explain to you the first tip, the first explanation as to why it is that I wake up so early in the morning. So, and this is perhaps one of the biggest reasons. There's absolutely zero distractions when you are up early in the morning. Think about it. All my roommates, all of my friends, they're all sleeping still. And then on top of that, even if I wanted to go on social media, no one's posting at 3 a.m. in the morning. And so when I wake up early in the morning, it forces me and holds me accountable to doing the most important, hardest tasks of the day first, because there's literally nothing else to do. So right now, I gotta jump into this webinar, so I will see you in a little bit to tell you the second point. Ugh. All right, so for the past 90 minutes or so, I've been working on this webinar presentation, and it's all done, ready to go, ready to present. So I'm super stoked about this. We are actually hiring something with someone within the company right now. So I'm going to go ahead and finalize this job offer for this individual. I'm about to hop on a call with him, and I'm really excited to onboard him onto our company team. So I'm going to hop on this call really quickly. Hey Ryan, how's it going?
All right, well, good news. We're on pace for week one. We should be able to crush this goal. All right, guys.
All right, thanks, guys.
This is great. I'm going to be killer.
See you later.
Hey, brothers.
Oh man, so after working on this webinar for the past week, I probably put about 10 to 15 hours into this. It is officially done. Check this out. This is for my mentor, Vince Del Monte's company, the 7-Figure Mastermind. And I think this is really gonna help us bring in more clients to join our coaching program.
So you can easily scale to your first 10, 20, 30K month and beyond.
Oh man, all right, so it is just about noon right now, so I'm gonna go ahead and make a quick lunch, but I wanna give you my second reason, and this is a really important one for why I wake up at 3:35 a.m. And that's essentially because it's my magic time. I define magic time as something that every single person has. And essentially what it is, it's the most focused period of time in your day. It's when you feel that your brain is the most sharp, you have the most clarity and focus. So if you think about it, for some people, when they first wake up for the first 3 hours, they feel like zombies and they can't think. That's clearly not their magic time. For some people, you might be a night owl and you might feel the most focused when it's past midnight. For myself, the magic time is exactly 1 hour after I wake up, because when I first wake up, my brain's still a little foggy, a little tired, still waking up. But after that first hour of waking up, my first 4 hours following that is the best time available. And I'd like to say for most people out there, that's probably the case as well, because you have the most energy in your gas tank before you get tired throughout the day. Back when I was a student, I would do all of my difficult studying and problem solving and memorization during this time. Now that I'm in business, whenever I'm doing deep work, that's what I like to call it. Essentially, when I'm focusing on difficult tasks such as building out a new sales funnel, a new process, something in which I need to be dealing with a whole bunch of moving parts, that's when I delegate this time for. So a little tip that I have for you is find out when exactly is your magic time. Wake up earlier, try different periods. Take more of an account of when you're the most focused, and you might just figure out that there's an early time or a later time that works really well for you. Make sure you plan out your wake up time according to that. So I'm gonna make lunch right now, and then I'm gonna tell you my third point in just a little bit. What do you think? Looks pretty good, eh? Oh man, all right, so I have been inside all day from 3 a.m. all the way until 12:30 right now at noon. And I wanna tell you my third point as I'm heading over to the gym. So the third reason why I wake up so early in the morning is because it helps me build momentum. And what I mean by that is, it's just a really good feeling when you get something done, right? So think about a time when you complete a test, you finish some kind of project, you launch some kind of product for your business. It feels really good to have a small accomplishment. Well, in the same way, waking up early is kind of cool because you know you're up and working when most people are still asleep. And if you're competitive like I am, it's a really good feeling of just feeling like you're getting ahead, that you're moving faster than your competition is. And so when I'm able to wake up early in the morning and get my day started early, that's a small win that I achieve. And then I hit a cold shower, that's another small win. And then I finish my prayer, and that's another small win. And when I begin to stack all these wins on top of each other, all of a sudden, I'm having a really, really good day, really, really early throughout the day. So those are the three main reasons as to why it is that I wake up early in the morning. I can give you a whole bunch of tips on how exactly you can get started waking up. So let me know if you want a really in-depth video on how to wake up earlier than you are right now. Go ahead and drop in the comments below, and I'm gonna head over to the gym. I'll see you soon. I have to take a couple quick two phone calls, clear some things with a couple clients for my business, and then we're gonna get a quick workout in. So, you wanna wake up earlier, but you're not too sure how. Well, let me know if you wanna see a more actionable video based off of how you can wake up earlier by dropping the comment down below. All right, so just got done with a really great workout. Man, that was a really exhausting and tough one, but got through it. So I was talking about a couple of the reasons why I wake up so early. Now, like I said, you don't necessarily have to wake up early as long as you're maintaining maximal productivity with the hours that you are awake. My first tip is gonna be the first one out of two. Now, the easy, slow route is if you don't want to go ahead and go cold turkey and all of a sudden one day wake up early, what you want to do is, first off, set a timer for when you go to bed. A lot of people set timers for when they wake up. However, a lot of times we forget we need to maintain a certain amount of sleep, typically 7 to 8 hours, in order to be fully functional and optimal during our waking time. So if you want to wake up, for example, at 6 a.m., what you want to do is maintain 7 hours of sleep. So that means you have to be in bed by 11 p.m. So you go ahead and set your timer for 10:30 p.m., which means as soon as that alarm goes off, it now signals that you have 30 minutes left before you must be in bed in order to wake up at 6 a.m. while getting 7 hours of sleep. So if you want to engineer it slowly, all you have to do is bring that timer back 30 minutes earlier and earlier and earlier every 2 to 3 days. That way, if you're currently waking up at 8 a.m., then you can dial it to 7:30, and then 7, 6:30, and all the way back to the desired time that you want. So that's the simple way. It definitely will take a little bit longer, but in my opinion, it's the most efficient way while not really impacting your quality of life. Now, I gotta go check some emails and wrap up on my workday, so I'm gonna share you the faster and harder way to go about it. It's personally the way that I go about it, waking up early. So I'll see you in a little bit. All right, so I just got done with a really productive session to conclude my day. Just had to respond back to some emails and Slack messages to the rest of the company team. And I wanna give you the second way to wake up early. And this is actually the way that I wake up early. It's the cold turkey harder method, but it's the fastest way in my personal opinion. So the way it works is essentially, if you're gonna bed at 12 a.m. right now, that means you're probably waking up around 7 a.m. because you wanna make sure you're still getting your 7 hours of sleep, right? But your target wake up time is 5 a.m. So that means all you have to do is go to bed at your normal time at midnight, but set your alarm for 5 a.m. on your phone or digital alarm clock. And so what's gonna happen, it's gonna go off, you're only gonna sleep for 5 hours, and it's gonna suck and it's gonna be really painful. But what's gonna happen is throughout the day, you just gotta tough it through, be a trooper. And by the end of the day, I promise you, you will be super, super tired early on in the day because you've been up for such an early time. The key here is you do not want to take a nap. If you take a nap, it ruins the whole purpose of getting you tired earlier in the day. But what ends up happening is because you woke up so early, you're gonna naturally go to bed earlier at an earlier time. So you're probably gonna go to bed at 10 p.m. And so what happens? If you go to bed at 10 p.m., you're only gonna sleep about 7 to 8 hours, which means you'll wake up the next day at 5 or 6 a.m. So it's perfect. It's the cold turkey method, it's what I do. And this past winter holiday season, I was waking up around 7, 8 a.m. I was traveling with family. Earlier this week, I did a cold turkey wake up at 3:30 a.m. I only slept for 5 hours and it really sucked. But you get over it over the course of literally 24 hours. It's like overcoming jet lag. So that's the second way. I hope that these two ways are really effective. So I'm gonna grab some dinner right now, grab some beef plate, and I will catch you guys in a little bit. How are you, miss? I will say without a doubt, beef plate is still the number one dining hall. I don't care what anyone says. Ranked in the nation, best food ever. All right, so I just got back to the apartment. Now, today in this video, I shared with you the three reasons why I wake up early in the morning. And then on top of that, I provided you with two super actionable ways to wake up earlier yourself if that's something that you want to do. So the tips are gonna be right there and the three reasons why are gonna be right there. Now, I wanted to ask something of you. So I'm gonna be making a training program, a course pretty soon, and I'm not sure which one it is that would be able to best serve you. One's gonna be on networking, in which I'm pretty much gonna explain exactly how I got to network and find mentors with entrepreneurs who are millionaires, multimillionaires, 100 millionaires, and how I've been able to do that through networking, my personality, and different forms and strategies. And then on top of that, I'm also thinking about making a program for high performance, something in regards to productivity and really trying to maximize your day. So let me know which one it is in the comments down below that you would really gain the most value from, because I'm only making this to best serve you. I want to serve you through this kind of content. And then on top of that, if you are looking for an entrepreneur mentor, I have a business called Entrepreneur Sidekick, in which I connect students who are in university with entrepreneurs who are making at least 6 figures every single year. So if you are interested, go ahead and follow these steps very closely. Step one, join the Facebook group. The link is gonna be down below. Step two, when you get into that Facebook group, there's gonna be a link at the top of the group. That's the Entrepreneur Sidekick letter. I wrote that letter for you. Give that a read, and it's gonna give you all the instructions on exactly how to apply. So follow those two steps. Join the Facebook group, read the letter, and all the instructions are gonna be in there. Lastly, I just wanted to remind you that this video is 100% free for you. And these videos take me about 10 to 15 hours every single week to edit, prepare, and film. And the reason why is because I just want to give you a lot of value and help you grow. And so my only ask of you, the fee to watch this video, is to take a picture, a screenshot of it, and tag it on your Instagram, share it with a friend, text it to your classmates, your family, your peers, okay? Because we want to get this channel up to 100,000 and impact as many people out there as possible. So for every video that you watch, my fee, my price I ask of you, is that you go ahead and share once every single week. All right, so I'm so grateful that you're able to do that. Thank you so much for that. And until next time, stay sharp, stay focused, and go crush it.